In this tutorial, we will show you how to define a new PV module for use in PVSYST simulations. We will show you how PV modules are defined in PVSYST. These models are stored in so-called PAN files. To do this, we will insert a new PAN file based on a datasheet. The datasheet used in this tutorial is provided as a PDF for download in the course. The first page of the datasheet describes general features of the PV module. This front page usually consists of promotional information. The second page gives the technical specifications of the module, which will be used by PVSYST. Most of the time, several power classes of the same PV module are gathered together on a single datasheet. You must create separate PAN files for each power class. In this example, we will use the 340-watt power class. To start, we will go to Databases, and then click on PV modules. In this tutorial, we are going to create a PAN file from scratch. However, in practice, it is often much easier to start from a similar PV module that is already present in the database, modify the main parameters according to the datasheet, and store it under a new name. To start a new PAN file, click on New, and a PV module dialog appears. This blue dialog box will tell you which parameter is required next. First, we will define the module description, which includes the model, manufacturer, data source, and file name. The convention in PVSYST is to define the file name of PV modules as manufacturer_model.pan. Next, we will input the nominal power and tolerance. For technology, the manufacturer has specified monocrystalline, so we will use SI-mono. Manufacturers will often supply both measurements at STC and NOCT. PVSYST only uses the STC measurements to build a model of the PV module. You can disregard the NOCT measurement when creating a PAN file. So now, we will add the measurement at STC in PVSYST. Next, we will input the temperature coefficient. In PVSYST, we use the ISC temperature coefficient, which is sometimes referred to as alpha. PVSYST can either use the value in milliamps per degree Celsius or percent per degree Celsius. In our datasheet, the value is given in percent per degree Celsius. Click on Sizes and Technology. It is mandatory to define the size of the module in PVSYST. It is also mandatory to define the number of cells in series and parallel. Please note that this concerns how the cells are electrically connected. Unless otherwise mentioned on the datasheet, you can assume that all cells are connected in series for a standard PV module, and that for twin half-cell modules, the cells are connected in two parallel strings. Note that the electrical connection does not mean the geometric arrangement of cells on the PV module, as is often specified on the datasheet. Optionally, you can input the cell area. This will allow PVSYST to calculate the efficiency at the cell level. The area needs to be in units of square centimeters. For the maximum array voltage, the IEC value is usually 1,000 volts for standard PV modules. Nowadays, more and more modules are specified for 1,500 volts to be used in high voltage PV systems. In the United States, some modules are specified for 600 volts due to special regulation rules for electrical systems. In this field, you enter the number of submodules, which is equal to the number of protection bypass diodes. This concerns functional bypass diodes, which define the partitioning of the module into submodules. Sometimes manufacturers connect two diodes in parallel, which makes six diodes for a standard PV module. However, in the PAN file, this has to be counted for as three functional bypass diodes. Manufacturers do not always provide the number of bypass diodes on the datasheet. If you do not know the number of bypass diodes, you can use a default value of 3 bypass diodes for standard 72 or 60 cell modules. The submodule partition for most modules has to be defined as in length, unless you are using twin half cell modules. For special modules such as tiled, concentrating PV, or bifacial cells, select from these checkboxes. Checking these boxes will bring up additional parameters necessary to properly create the PAN file. This free text field allows you to describe special properties or features of the module in up to 4 lines of text. Once the sizes and technology are properly set, a tab called Model Parameters will appear. The Model Parameters page defines the parameters that are specific to the PVSYST one diode model. They do not show up on the datasheets. Some of these parameters are derived from the values entered in the Basic Data tab. PVSYST calculates values for series and shunt resistance automatically based on the STC measurements in Basic Data. Unless you have measured values for these resistances, you should leave them as their default values. Click on the radio button for relative efficiency. The R series value mainly determines the low light performance of the PV module. The default value set by PVSYST for crystalline silicon is -3% at an irradiance of 200 watts per square meter. If this value is not reachable, the value for R shunt should be increased. In the lower part, you find specific parameters determined by the model. Here, the mu VOC temperature coefficient is a result of the model. It will not necessarily match the value on the datasheet. The tab R shunt exponential shows how the shunt resistance depends on the irradiance. In the absence of measured values, leave these parameters at their default values. The temperature coefficient page describes the temperature dependence of the maximum power point. To ensure that this value is exactly matched, PVSYST slightly modifies the standard one diode model. To use this function, click on the checkbox Apply the Correction and enter the PMPP temperature coefficient as given in the datasheet, where it is sometimes called gamma. The Additional Data page contains optional data which is normally not found in the datasheet. If you have information on these values, you can fill them in. Else, you should just leave the values empty or at their default values. Mostly, it is the Customized IAM page where you might want to make a change. Here you define the IAM function based on Fresnel's laws. The default front surface is normal glass. You should choose AR coating only if this is explicitly mentioned on the datasheet. Now the PV module is fully defined and we can have a look at the results of the one diode model. On the Basic Data page on the bottom left part, you find the Internal Model Result tool that calculates the electrical behavior of the PV module for any irradiance and temperature conditions. You can, for example, put in 200 watts per square meter for the irradiance and 30 degrees Celsius for the cell temperature, and immediately see how the PV module performs at these conditions. On the graphs page, you can get a more complete picture of the model behavior. You can see several plots for this PV module, like the IV curves or the efficiency versus irradiance curves, where you can see, for example, the low light efficiency. Now the PV module is fully defined. When exiting this dialog, PVSyst will prompt you to save your modifications. Clicking on Save will store this new PAN file in your PVSyst workspace. You will be able to use it in your projects. In this tutorial, we explained that PV module definitions are stored in PVSyst as PAN files. We also showed how to make a new PAN file from a PV module datasheet.